£20. Yes, dear, there you are.
£20 exactly, dear.
Thanks. I don't know if you're interested, but we've just got tickets for Gay Pride on sale today.
I beg pardon?
Tickets for Gay Pride. They're £10 cheaper if you get them in advance.
How very dare you! I've never been so insulted.
Welcome to New Zealand.
Thank you so much.
So exciting to have you here.
Aww.
What have you liked about so far about our hotel rooms? Because I'm pretty sure that's all you've seen.
That's all I've seen, and I noticed that the room we're in now is a lot bigger than the one I'm staying in.
That's not right. You need to have a word with somebody about
that. And they're all lovely rooms, as we know. But as we've all checked out, the bathroom in this one has a double shower.
It's got a double shower.
Although travelling on my own, I suppose I can't really demand a double shower.
I think you can. You're Catherine Tate. Damn it, you can demand
whatever
you want.
One shower for the shampoo and the other for the conditioner.
Imagine that, it'd be good. I know, I was actually, I promised myself I wasn't going to do this, but, you know.
You're going to ask me for money?
No, well, I thought about that. That was my second question. But I had to, I thought, I can't go through a whole interview without doing it. Are you bothered?
Do I look bothered?
Are you bothered?
Do I look bothered?
Are you bothered?
But no, I look at my face.
Are you bothered?
Are you looking at my face?
Are you bothered?
Are you looking at my face? Is any part of it bothered? No, because I ain't bothered.
But I ain't bothered!
Many people would know you from a multitude of things, but let's start with the Catherine Tate Show.
Sure.
And all of your characters that you've had. I mean, Nan.
I ain't never seen such ugly child.
Lauren Cooper.
Yes.
Lauren Cooper. Geordie Georgie as well.
Oh, yeah.
So many good characters. Is Lauren... Is she you? Is she you now? And is Nan future you?
Very possibly. I think there was probably a touch of me as that in the teenage years.
I think there's a touch of that in everybody.
Everyone.
In teenage years.
I think they walk among us.
What, shame on your family?
I don't care because I don't even like them.
But you shame them, though.
I don't even care because I don't even like them.
But they're your parents, though.
No, they ain't, though.
Yes, they are, though.
No, they ain't, though.
Why'd you live with them, then?
Are you disrespecting my family?
And Nan was somebody that you actually picked up when you were performing in a rest home, is that right?
I had the idea of doing the voice. Yeah, exactly. When I was at college, they sent a few of us round to an old people's home to give them a trip down memory lane, and they weren't particularly interested in coming with us. We were singing all some like wartime songs or something to, you know, get them into the swing of it, and they didn't like it. And one old lady,
she just said, "Oh, get out of the way of the TV."
She said something a lot ruder, but I know this is daytime show, so I can't repeat it. Yeah. But it was just shot through the room, and I remember thinking, oh, that's a great voice.
All of your characters have a sort of slight similarity, and they're quite belligerent. Was that intentional?
I suppose so. No, do you know what? It wasn't. It was just I realised, I guess that's the place where I just go to easily, is belligerence. But, yeah, they all are fairly, well, they're deeply flawed, all of them. And, belligerent, I suppose.
And this live show that you're doing, which is obviously based on your characters, you bring. Yeah. How many characters are you actually bringing?
It's about 18, I think.
18?
That's a lot, yeah.
So how do you do that? How do you get off stage quickly and change? Because I'm sure Nan, who's quite a scraggy old woman, she must take a bit of prosthetics.
Well, the strange thing about that is, in the TV show, the Nan character takes about 2 hours in makeup because it's all really prosthetic. We obviously can't do that on a live show. And they were saying, oh, no, we can get you a kind of a bit of a, you know, it's more of a pull over your head mask done. It didn't work. It didn't work at all. And then we realised, actually, because you don't have cameras on you and the audience are quite a long way away, any form of prosthetic is not really worth it. You've got the wig and you've got the costume and then you've got the thing. Horrifically, nobody noticed that I didn't actually wear the prosthetic. But you just become her, and kind of people, they either forget or they forgive, because they know that after the first five rows, you can't see it anyway.
So when you're backstage, it must be really incredibly lined up to backstage. So when you're side of stage getting changed, everything would have to be in its place, wouldn't it? Because you want to be on and off stage before people even know.
I mean, obviously, the way you do it is having brilliant quick change artists backstage who are superb at what they do. And you have to sort of kind of rehearse the moves backstage almost like a dance, because you know that this arm's going in first, this arm's going in, something's being ripped off of the back, someone else is pulling off your shoes, you've got to put this leg in first. Right. You know, it's really like that. So you've got to be working all the time. Yeah, it's a real jiggle.
So if you're sitting right side of stage, like if you're in the audience and you're right side of stage, you might see a bit of boobage on Nan as she's doing a quick change, or is it?
We try to avoid it, but if you pay enough,
there'll be definitely
get the gold
boobage.
Seat.
That's extra. That's the VIP.
That's the VIP package, we call that.
And you're bringing friends with you on this tour, including Nikki Waters. She's been your mate, since drama school?
We met We met after drama school, but we realised we've known each other 18 years this year, which is like, oh my gosh.
And so, and she's been on the show with you. She was obviously Lauren Cooper's best friend.
Absolutely, yeah.
And so you're basically travelling the world with one of your best mates.
Absolutely.
Doing this.
A joy. Yeah, really, really.
He blew me out. Can you believe that? I was like, are you joking me with this? And he was like, don't start giving me grief. And I goes, well, you better stop vexing me then.
That is so dry. That boy's taking liberties.
Where did the idea for the stage show come from?
From the show, you know, there's no theme or concept. It is really just doing the show live. Obviously, all the sketches are new. And I always wanted to tour. I just never found the right time. I've only ever done it about 18 months ago in the UK. We toured, October to December or something. And that was it. So, and I've never toured before. Because when they said, do you want to do a tour of Australia and New Zealand? My first thing was, could I? You know what I mean? It's like,
does
anyone know? I don't know. And I guess that remains to be seen. But to have the opportunity to do it is great. And it's a show I think honestly it's the best thing I've done. I'm so proud of it. It's such a blast.